Now consider AC voltage applied to a pure resistor circuit. So let us imagine a resistor connected to an AC source. So this is an AC source to which a resistor is connected. Let EMF is E and current is I. Let us say the EMF applied to the AC resistor is E is given by E naught sin omega t. Now if I apply Ohm's law, we know that I is equal to E by R because V is equal to IR. So this gives E naught sin omega t divided by R. So this I will write as E naught by R times sin omega t. This is our I naught into sin omega t. So peak value of the current I naught is given by peak value of EMF divided by resistance. Suppose if I draw a graph between E and T and also I and T. So let us first consider the graph is drawn with time on the x-axis and EMF on the y-axis. E is E naught sin omega t. Is a sine graph. So I can represent the graph like this. So this is 0 time, t by 2, this is t seconds. This value is E naught. Now suppose if I draw the I graph on the same thing. I also I want to represent. Already we know I is also equal to I naught sin omega t. So if I again draw the graph, but I naught is E naught by R into sin omega t. So for this E naught sin omega t, this is 1 by R times that value. So I can represent like this. This is because both are sine curves only. So this is our I naught. This is E naught. This is I naught. So if I observe these two equations, we can say whenever EMF becomes maximum, current is also maximum. Whenever EMF becomes zero, current is zero. Again EMF maximum, EMF or induced voltage, current is maximum. EMF 0, current is 0. So they are said to be in phase. When a pure resistor is connected to an AC source, EMF and current are said to be in phase. So we can represent the phasor diagram like this. So if I say this is my EMF, then current is also same direction, same one only. This is current. So that's why both are said to be in phase. When AC is applied to a pure resistor circuit, EMF and current both are in phase. Now what is the power here? Since they are in same phase, in phase, that means phi is equal to 0 or cos phi is equal to 1. Therefore power P is given by E into I. Instantaneous power we are taking. P is nothing but E into I. This is E naught sin omega t into I naught sin omega t. So that is E naught I naught times sin square omega t, the power of the circuit. Suppose if you take average power, this is instantaneous power, this one. Now average power, we know that P average is equal to ERMS into IRMS into cos phi, but cos phi value is 1, therefore this is equal to ERMS times IRMS. Since cos phi is 1, but I is nothing but E by R. So similarly, ERMS is also equal to same. Therefore, we can write as ERMS whole square divided by R. The average power in a resistor, when a pure resistor is connected to an AC source, this is E square RMS, ERMS square divided by R.